Welcome, Tatiana. We are here to talk about your biography about Daphné du Maurier. It sold already 80,000 copies in France alone.
Very good news, which I was not expecting, and I hope it'll do well in the Netherlands as well.
So why did you write a biography about Daphné?
Well, I hadn't had the idea of writing about Daphné. In fact, I had never thought about it myself, but I was approached by a French publisher, and he had noticed that I always mentioned her in my interviews. And so he said, you would be the perfect person. And I thought about it. I was a bit panicked at first because I've never written a biography and I didn't really know how to go about it. But then I realized that this was really a challenge and I had to accept it. So that's how it all started, but it was somebody else's idea.
And your husband pushed you?
And my husband pushed me. He said to me, you know, you've been talking to me about Daphné du Maurier for nearly 30 years. So if you don't write this book and somebody else will,
exactly,
you will die of jealousy because she's your Daphné. I decided to go to Cornwall, which is where she lived and died, and to go and see all the houses that she had lived in. And once I had all this information, which was a lot, then I had to find my own way into this mass of work. There are already three existing biographies. I did not want to do the same thing. I wanted to choose my path into that. So I guess my questions were, how was I going to introduce this author who was very highly read in the 60s, 70s, 50s, much less now? And most importantly, how I was going to show the way she became this famous writer, how she wrote her books, where she got her inspiration from. That's really how I built the book.
You were determined to find her secrets or discover her secrets. What kind of secrets did you find?
Well, you know, she's a writer who loves secrets. I mean, all her books are filled with secrets. She had a very secretive life. She was, on one side, a perfect wife, mother, charming, sometimes a little shy, didn't like appearing in public. And then on the other hand, she was this mysterious writer. She had a fascination for houses, for walls, for memories that take place in houses. And she had a secret life of her own. Mm-hmm. She had secret affairs that nobody knew about. Some with women, some with men. She was a very secret person. She would have hated, actually, anybody talking about her life the way we are doing now.
What can we learn from Daphné's life?
Her freedom. So many people have said to me, oh, but she's a selfish woman. And I reply, I don't agree with that. If she were a man, would you be saying the same thing?
If we really want to understand Daphné du Maurier, which book should we really read?
I think that, you need to read all her books, of course. But you could start with Rebecca, because Rebecca is her most famous book, although it's not completely representative of all her talent. Rebecca is a very dark story with a terrifying final twist. It has no end. That's what I love about most of her work.
Would you could have fallen in love with her?
I think so.
Yeah?
Yeah, I would have found her very menacing, to use the du Maurier code word, menacing meaning attractive.
Yeah, that's a
whole look at her.
Yeah.
I mean, she was just
amazing. Yeah.
And then when you see those films of her, the way she walks, you know, she had an incredible personality.
Wasn't it hard to capture her real soul then?
No. No, it wasn't, because it all comes out in her books. The hard thing was when I finished the book.
To let her go.
Yes, I don't think I have. I think she's still there, my husband's despair. Because I still spray her perfume around the house.
Really? Yeah.
Vent Vert by Balmain. Every time I spray
it. You still do that?
I do that from time to time, and then he says, Bing is here.